Next, we have the activation function. If you remember, this is how we calculate the output of one layer. Remember, these are the vectors. This is the weight vector of the whole layer. This is the input that we got from the previous layer. And this is the bias of each of the neurons. And this big A, the capital A, tells us it's basically one big matrix or one big vector of all the outputs of the neurons in one layer. The activation function is a thing that helps us learn or fit into complex problems. Because as I said, if you have a linear function, especially in the hidden layers, then you're not going to be able to learn complex patterns in the data. We mentioned it before, ReLU is a good one to start with for your hidden layers. And for the output layer, whatever activation function you choose is going to be based on the output. So if you want a binary one, you're going to choose something that's going to give you an output. It's either 0 or 1. If you want a regression problem, for example, then you might not even want to use a activation function. But again, in the summary notes, you're going to see more about this. So you can read about it and choose one that's best for you. Again, we will talk about activation functions in more detail soon, because there are some problems that can be solved by the activation function that you use, but we'll talk more about that in the coming lessons. Batch size. So batch size is basically batching is dividing the data set into different chunks and learning or taking that learning step with each and every batch. This is done because it makes it a bit faster to learn, so you don't have to run through the whole data to make the updates. But it's also done to be able to generalize better for the whole data. So basically stops us from overfitting to the whole training set, because we only see parts of it, right? We only train on parts of it. And then every time we do the one epoch, then we will only see parts of the data. And then we do the same thing again and the same thing again. And basically, we've seen that batching in this way will help us make more accurate predictions at the end. But this is, again, something we will talk about in more detail in the coming lessons. Batching kind of goes with gradient descent, so don't be surprised if you all are over the place, you hear it like something gradient descent, like batch gradient descent, mini batch gradient descent, and stochastic gradient descent. These things are actually very simple. Batch gradient descent means before you do the gradient descent step, which is updating the weights and biases, batch gradient descent means that you will do that learning layer only after the whole data set has been run through the data or has been run through the network. So one batch is the whole data set, basically. Mini batch is anywhere between having one input or one data point in our batch to having all of it. So anywhere in between that. Stochastic gradient descent is one batch equals to one data point. So you show your network one data point, it calculates and it updates the weights. You show it another data point, it updates the weights. So these are all different types of gradient descent. They all have upsides and downsides, but we will talk about them later. Number of iterations is something that we already talked about in the exercise. So this will be something that will depend on your network specifically. So you can use early stopping, something called early stopping, to decide when you should stop, because the more you show your model, your data, the more it's going to learn, And of course, after some point, it's going to start to overfit. And what that's going to look like is training loss is going to keep going down. Training accuracy is going to keep getting higher, which means that your model is fitting the data better and better and better. Whereas on the validation set, you're going to see that the accuracy is starting to go down and validation loss is starting to get higher. So you can either do this manually, you can see one by one which one is better, you can increase it, and at some point maybe you'll see, okay, my validation accuracy is going down, so I'm going to roll back a little bit. Or you can do this automatically with early stopping. We'll see it in some of our exercises.